So what is armature reaction? Let's again consider that my north and south pole are there. This is my north pole and south pole. The direction of my MMF phi is this way. So and there are not two conductors now, there are a lot of conductors. This again, a lot of conductors are there on a armature core. So suppose now current is going, suppose inside here, since this there is no interaction here, no current will be going, so the current will be coming out. Sorry, the current is coming out on the north pole, suppose, and it's going in the south pole. And since this is magnetically neutral axis, so no current is in these two conductors at position B and D. Again, this is point A, this is point B, R. So no current at point B and D, so no EMF generated. So that's why they are magnetic neutral axis. So when the current is here, I can see that from the right hand rule, this is my right hand. If this is the direction of the current is showed by my thumb, so the in which my fingers are moving, that will be the direction of the magnetic flux and the conductor. Since the conductor's current is coming up here, so conductor's current is coming up, so the direction of the flux would be magnetic field due to the conductor would be in this direction. So in this direction, and it will interact with this, so it will be here like this. In these two conductors, it would be like this, and here it would be like this. In the same way, I will be having interaction over here. The current, it would be like here, it will be like the current is going the inwards, so direction will be clockwise. This would be the clockwise direction, and due to these two conductors, the direction would be like this. And if some more conductors are there, so there will be some more interactions also. So one can see this is now very clumsy. So one can see that here, this is the direction of my conductor's MMF under the north pole. Here it is anti-clockwise. Here it is here like this. Here it is clockwise under south pole. It is clockwise. You can see this is clockwise direction. Here it is upward, here is also it is upward, here is also upward, here also upward. So one can see that my actual direction of MMF is here due to north and south pole of my generator. Whereas the direction here, it is not aiding. The direction is here like this, but it is going, it is distorting it. It is going in this way. So it is demagnetizing in this way. Here it is magnetizing in this way. Here again it is demagnetizing, here it is magnetizing. So this part is magnetizing, this part is also magnetizing, but this part is non-magnetizing, this part is magnetizing again. So there is a mismatch of actual direction of flux, which is my disk flux, and at the center I can see all the directions are upwards. Here it is up, here it is up, here it is up, here it is up. Everything is going up. So there is a resultant of this here in the magnetic and neutral axis. So for a clear picture, I can have another this one that the direction of flux here due to north and south pole is this, but there is a flux in this direction due to my conductors also. So I was expecting there is no MMF, there is no flux in my magnetic and neutral zone. This is D, this is B in the magnetic and neutral zone. But at the practical view, there is a flux in this direction which is going upward. So it means that the assumed direction of magnetic and neutral axis is now shifted somewhere else, because now the resultant of these two, this is phi because of conductor, this is phi action, so the resultant would be somewhat here. The direction of geometrical neutral axis, this is geometrical neutral axis which is passing through north and south pole, and this is my magnetic and neutral axis. Assume magnetic and neutral axis when there was no current flowing in the conductor. So previously I placed my brushes over here, here and here, and this was my commutator and conductor and all that, but the direction, but I placed my brushes over here because this was magnetically neutral axis toward the sparking, toward the I square R losses, and from here I was having a external circuit, and from here the load was connected and the current I was one here. Now since there is a flux in this direction, I cannot keep my this is the direction of my rotor. So I can clearly see that I cannot keep my brushes on this direction now. When the current started flowing, I cannot keep my brushes in this magnetic and neutral axis, assume magnetic and neutral axis. So I have to shift them in such a way that while commutation, there should not be any sparking, there should not be any circulating current. So since my actual direction of flux, phi, resultant is like this now, so my magnetically neutral has shifted here. This is my new magnetically neutral axis now, this line. So rather than putting my brushes over here, I have to shift my brushes here now. So this is a very good concept regarding the shifting of the brushes. The shifting of brushes in DC generator is to avoid the sparking, to avoid the or to have the good commutation is in the direction of the rotation in case of generator. So the in generator they are giving a forward shift. Since this was my previous direction, so I have forwarded it by some angle, suppose it's theta, and I have shifted my brushes in a new position. Now this is my magnetical interaxis. So now I have to keep my brushes here. Now one more question arises here, that when my load is fluctuating, but obvious, when my load is getting increased, so my current I will increase. So previously my MMF was here due to my conductor. Now since the current has increased in the conductor, the current has increased, so my MMF would also be increasing. Suppose here now, previously it was here, now here. So may be possible that previous resultant was here, now my resultant is coming here. Again, now this is changed. So but obvious, may be possible that my brush will shift here or here, wherever possible. There could be this much of a stretch to place my brushes according to the current. But in a normal practice, brushes are fixed. I cannot move those brushes according to the load current, because the load current can vary according to the condition of the load, according to fluctuation, according to maybe possible that now I am in need of a lesser load, so the current will decrease, so the MMF will also decrease. So maybe possible that this may come here, so my brush will be here now. Now I have increased the load, the current is increasing, so I will put it here, 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 here. So that much of stretch would be there for the brushes to have the good combination. So is that practically possible? No, it's not possible. I need to have some other arrangement to do this thing. I cannot keep on changing my brushes from here to there by an angle of almost 30 to 40 degrees. That is not possible. Practically, that is not possible inside the generator, because generator is totally packed. I cannot keep on changing my brushes. So for solving this thing, there is another thing